Hey everybody, it's Scorch A2. Welcome back to another episode of First Fireups, where we join into the world of mages, deckers, hackers, and the megacorps. We are playing Shadowrun Returns, brought to us by Harebrained Schemes, another take on the classic Shadowrun series, which is based off of tabletop games. This is going to be an XCOM style, like isometric point-and-click strategy type game, where we delve once again into the world of Shadowrun, taking place in the distant future of Seattle. So let's go ahead and check out some of the options here. Let's see, free camera mode, HD detectors. A lot of these things are probably not going to be very obvious until we start playing. Let's play on game difficulty normal, text speed normal. Double click is probably for assigning actions. For now, let's just stick with the same. Reward code unlock. I, for whatever reason, did not back this on Kickstarter. It's probably because I didn't even know it was available to be backed until after it had already ended. I think somebody mentioned it to me when I played my playthrough of Super Nintendo's version of Shadowrun, which is awesome, by the way. If you haven't seen that, go check it out. Until then, let's get out of the options. I set my resolution already, so I would have the proper recording resolution to do this. Hopefully this game lets me record and doesn't like freeze, because some games played on Steam fucking hate being recorded. So let's go ahead and jump into a new game. This game features the ability to play user-generated content. This is the one that came by the team that developed it, Harebrained Schemes, the Dead Man's Switch. Urban sprawl of the Seattle Metroplex, the search for a mysterious killer sets you on a trail that leads you from the darkest slums to the city's most powerful megacorpse. Whatever. You will need to tread carefully, enlist the aid of other runners, and master powerful forces of technology and magic in order to emerge from the shadows of Seattle unscathed. Alright. So, this game released today on Steam. It's $20. More than worth it, I'm sure, just for it being Shadowrun, but then again, anybody who's played the first-person shooter that came out a couple of years ago will probably know that it sucked ass, so hopefully that doesn't happen here. But there's already some user-generated content on it, so even today it's pretty quick. What do we want to play as? We got human. Humans were the only race on Earth until the Awakening in 2012. Definition of average or even normal. Still the most populous race in the world, and thus control many of the most powerful, moneyed, and important positions in society. Plus one to karma at the start of the game. This is going to be real quick on the RPG factor here. Let's look at the elves. Mostly acceptable in other metahumans. Elves are taller than humans, but have a more slender build. Hair is usually thicker, longer, more luxurious than average. Their ears come to a point. Plus one to charisma. That means they speak well. Maximum stats, body 9, quickness 11, strength 9, charisma 12. A dwarf. An orc. Let's see, plus 1 to willpower. Plus 1 to body. Orcs are the fastest breeding race, and now are only second to human in world population. Besides, size leads to an intimidating silhouette and a body that can take more physical damage than the average. Orcs have pointed ears and intimidating teeth or tusks. And a troll. Largest metahuman race. Heavy prejudice against them has led people to assume trolls have lowered intelligence. In reality, there's no proof of this. Plus one to body and strength. They're not very charismatic. Probably going to be doing a lot on their own, or at least having to pay for it. I think we should play as an orc. Looks like here is our archetype, street samurai. It's kind of like perks in Fallout. Let's see, decker. They're good for hacking and doing stuff like that. Shaman is magic. Rigor. Key attributes: intelligence, drone control, physical adept. Let's see. What are we? Body, quickness. Probably should pick something that sort of aligns with what we're doing. Let's do physical adept. This is us, or that's us. Look, it's Bane. I'm not sure I like that one. These portraits look cooler than the rendered graphics, but he's trying too hard to look human. I kind of like that guy. He's got the cool eye. Let's go with this guy. Hairstyle. Apparently this is auto, so we can undo it and do it ourselves. Let's keep going. Spend your karma. Karma represents the experience characters earn while running in the shadows and achieving goals. Karma is used to improve attributes and skills. An attribute or skill rating can be increased by spending karma equal to the next increment of that rating. So, if you're trying to increase to level 4, you gotta spend 4. See, we have 5 karma. Ranged combat. Now these are the only two we can upgrade. Is quickness, use to calculate chance to hit in ranged combat. Should get some equipment and pistols. Let's see. Increases the chance for greater than normal damage when using a pistol to attack. Increasing this skill unlocks special abilities. So we have to increase ranged combat. Let's do quickness. And confirm. Name my character. Blorch. Let's do it. Loading. Down and out. Your apartment, 3 o'clock in the morning. It's got 4 walls, a roof, and isn't on fire. Even the cockroaches have fled in search of better accommodations. Running the shadows is all about feast or famine. One day you're a Nova Hot working jobs that allow you to eat at 5-star restaurants. Next, well, you're here. It's kind of a little bit of a build-up into our world. Nowhere to go but down. Left-click moves your character. Clicking farther away causes him to run. Right-clicking so far doesn't do anything. You can see where I can interact. Calendar contacts, that kind of thing. View your list of contacts. Fixer, no response to messages. Doubt is dead. Sad dread up. Missing since February. Medfish went mad. And the gun shot himself. Alright, so we don't have that. All ends in people that are dead. It's empty, nothing to do. Put down my notebook. Answer my video phone. It's calling me at 3 a.m. So far, no voice acting. Screen leaps to life, making you squint against brightness. Face on the screen is laughing Sam Watts. Hey, buddy. Hope I didn't catch you at a bad time. He's drunk again, or worse. Shouldn't have given you my damn... My comm code, gonk. You're zoned. Bother with your side of the conversation. I'm not really here. Just one reason for this vid. Someone finally geeked me. I'm dead. Probably had it coming. Oh, shitty. Being called from beyond the grave. When you're an unsavory character like myself, you tend to associate with other unsavory characters who often partake in unsavory business, like you, for example. So why am I dead? Who knows? Probably my fault. So the one bad thing about not having voice acting is I have to read everything, or at least I feel like I have to read everything to you. Some people don't like being read to, so maybe I'll paraphrase some things. Let's see. Remember that Rinkaru run when things went to hell and we lost Dowd? That makeshift saloon on the docks afterward, I really had your back that night, didn't I? That's the name you haven't heard in a long time, but I saw it in the notebook. The not having voice acting, at least amidst the game, is nice because it takes you back to like the days where you actually had to read text, like a text-based RPG. So that's kind of cool. I like that's a nice touch. Sangoma. New Larry. New Larry looks like a ghost. New Larry for about 6 months now. He's a combat mage with a bad tattoo and a bad attitude. He knew Dowd almost as well as you did. Never saw anybody like you. Shakes his head. I hate this fragging city, Blorch. It's It's wet and the rain feels like acid. I want out of here. Shut your screamer about the rain. We lost a man tonight. We wait for the money, gotta get it, and take a pill and relax. Sure, of course. Sam's a good guy. Can't hold his own in a fight. But he's been hitting the bottle pretty good lately. Never on a run so far, but he needs watching. The rain went sideways, 9 ways to Sunday. Now the fixer is late. Smell funny to you? That bastard better show up. I got paid as much as you do. New yen is the currency of choice in the world of Shadowrun. Cut the dreck. Cut the shit. We both know why Dowd went down, and it wasn't the fixer or some other paranoid chip dream of yours. Sam smiles a toothy smile. I've been waiting for this all night. New Larry has something he wants to say. Don't you, Larry? Go ahead, spill it. You were sloppy. Sloppy? You think I was sloppy? You've been twitchy all day. Look at your hands. They're shaking. Huh. Did you miss a beat back there? No, Blorch. I didn't miss a beat. I was on my game the whole time. Remember, I was on point. New Larry's supposed to cover Dowd. Something dawns on him. He leans into New Larry, amused and dangerous. We were set up and he knows it, don't you, Larry? Come, he didn't geek that guy before I unloaded on Dowd. I wonder if we'll see reference to our old buddy Jake Armitage. Suppose they could do that. Let's see where this is going. You chummers are damaged. I'm out. He stops. Look that way. Sorry, Blorch. I kinda liked you. Just felt like I money better. Oh god. This guy is dirty. Mueller relaxes and throws you a dreck eating grin. Looks like my new Rinkaru friends are finally here. They're gonna take that hard drive off your corpse. Well, we should choose our friends. At least we have each other. Buy you a drink? You owe me several. Oh, that's awful. It's gonna be turn-based. Like I said, XCOM style, turn-based combat. You're in turn-based combat mode. Each character on your team is an action pool. Spend these actions on movement, attacks, or using spells and items. Once your team's turn is complete, the enemy team will move and attack. Additional tutorial information is available from the reference guide. Just free access to the upper right corner of the PDA menu. Alright, so it looks like... I'm trying to find where the action pool is. Interface is kind of similar to Fallout. It's not terribly intuitive, but I'm sure I just have to move somewhere. New Larry is an asshole. Kind of cool combat music. Looks like it lets an automatic, fuck you! It's an automatic cover there. See, this is me. I rule. Let's go over and attack him. Stab him with my knife, and I missed. That is the worst. Careful not to hit myself. Can I hit him again? I can. Fuck you, new Larry. Oh no! You missed. Here I am. You can choose what you want to do. Add plus 1 HP to the weapon's damage. It's like our special skill. Let's slash this guy. Oh, you fuck. I am the worst. There we go. 86%. There you go, you're dead. Let's move. Looks like he's got 2 action points. So that must be the action pool. This guy probably won't be able to be seen. Let's move over here. That'll spend his action and I'll get hit. Uh-oh, where are these guys coming from? Smash! Ugh, dude. Really? You're dead. There we go. Now this guy, gotta protect ourselves from the incomings. Let's see, now where do I end my turn at? Must be here. Missed. You missed. Lorch. You gotta make your way over there, buddy. Your old buddy Blorch. Sam Watts. Let's see, let's flank this guy. Let's see, I can scroll around by holding the right mouse wheel, or right mouse button. I don't see an option to, I can zoom in and out with the wheel. I don't see an option to rotate the screen. That could be annoying until I figure that out. Let's see. It's outside the movement range, so let's move here, and then we can fire on these guys. Whoa! Don't do that. Fuck you, bro. I'm gonna move myself here. I'll hit you. You're dead. I'm out of ammo. That's not good. This is bad. They have a shaman. Looks like I have to reload for one thing. Reload for one. Who's the shaman? Line of sight blocked. Crap. I gotta watch out. Oh god, that's not good. You missed, monster. Oh, that sucked. You're gonna have to not miss. Fuck. Rinkaru Mage. Six damage. Kill this asshole. Don't miss. Thank God. Run away! It's pretty crazy for the first fight. Ow. Let's see, who do I want to hit? I don't want to go over there. Let's hit this asshole. Oh, god damn it. There we go. Kill you. And then you. Ow. What a bitch. That's right, you missed. Let's kill this guy. Thank God. I'm gonna go hide. I don't want that guy to shoot me. There we go. I win! Sangoma lowers her gun. Eyes, Sam. You okay, Sam? Oh, eyes, Sam. I see. Haha! Sam's breathing is heavy and he looks shaken. That was a hell of a thing. It's part of life, Sam. You know that. You did good. You don't look so good. You were born for this gig, Blorch. Me, not so much. I'm gonna hang it up. Find a nice brothel somewhere. Stay drunk till I croak. That's a good plan, bro. What about you? I'll find a safe house. I have a long memory. I do too. I don't forget my friends. Thanks, buddy. That was cool. Not as involved, at least so far, as XCOM. But not too bad so far. Stare at Sam's face on your comm link. Shake off your memory. Shake off the memory. One thing I have to say is that the chance to hit on a melee, for me at least, for starting out character, maybe it was designed that way. It's kind of shitty. It's kind of like it was in Fallout 2, where it was like impossible to hit anything. I had your back that night, didn't I? Now I'm asking myself, who would care if I die? Who would give a rat's ass? I set up Dead Man's Switch to send you this call. It's kind of cool. So as soon as you die, it kicks off this call. Got 100,000 new in insurance policy payable when you find who creased me. Alive, with a conviction, or in a body bag with justification. Either works. Contact my law firm, Rogers, Mengert, and McCain. When the job is done, I'll know what to do. Chet? Camera swivels to show a well-dressed man sitting next to Sam. Pursuant to Mr. Watts' wishes, Rogers, Mengert, and McCain has installed a secure dedicated phone line, so you may contact us directly when the task is complete. Then begin the verification process. Note that you must also be on a secured landline to access this number. Not accept transmissions from comlinks or other devices. No cell phones, buddy. Look, Blorch, I've led a direct life, and I probably have left a direct corpse. I've hurt people, hurt myself, don't know. Just want the last word. Want someone to give a crap that I sucked air for a while. What do you say? I'd say my schedule's pretty clear. Drinking buddy for a paycheck. Buys a lot of drinks. I like drinks, but I'm not a drunkard. Someone's gonna pay. I hope he just said yes. That's right, because I'm not talking to him. It's kind of surreal, actually. Got a locator chip slotted in my head these days. If when my heart stops, it'll activate. That's how you find me. See you on the slab. So I'm heading back to Seattle. Alright. Dead Man's Switch. And we begin. It's kind of like a prologue. Ask the coroner about Sam Watts. I'm in the back. Ask the coroner about Samwise. Smell of death and decomposition wash over you, only slightly masked by the minty fake fresh of industrial grade antiseptic. Hey, Dresden, what's up? Nice. Hovering over the recently departed, it's a small dwarf whistling a tune. Love my job, a little more than you'd want to expect from someone in a chop shop trade. Sorry, I didn't expect any visitors. Some asshole at corporate took my receptionist. What can I do? Probably. John Dresden, the organ grinder's branch manager here. And you are? I represent a man. No one that you've heard of, now tell me about Sam Watts. Wow. Could be a dick right away. I should talk like an orc. Lorch. The locator chip. He's here. Not too many people know about the murder yet, though. Press haven't caught wind of it. That's probably good. Fuck the press. Sam's digital ghost. It's a recorder message asking me to bring his killer to justice. Guess he had a hunch. Not telling this guy about the money. He'll want in on it. Dead Man's Switch, eh? Fascinating. He's over here. Alright, you tell me where he's at. Oh, I'm supposed to follow you. Okay. I can already tell that when I scroll my mouse to the right, since I've got a second monitor on that side, the mouse pointer goes off the screen. That's a no-no. That can cause problems for games where you have to use the sides of the screen to scroll. So I'm trying not to click out there. My second Emerald City Ripper victim. This third was in downtown. Ripper, eh? What's that? Not my title. That's what the Seattle press insists on calling the killer. Like an original Jack, but our Ripper knows how to handle a scalpel. Wow. What price did he take? cleanly cut out. How about the other Luckies? Let's see, third out of spleen, a heart. Maybe he's making a Frankenstein. McCluskey wants Dresden out there. Let's steal. Take it. Item picked up, basic med kit. Take it off the body. Sam's body's half covered by a sterile surgical sheet. Ash and white. Several plastic envelopes containing evidence found on his body. You can examine evidence through the bag without spoiling it. Look at the business card. Things around the seamstress's union. Cred stick, standard cheap, unsecured cred stick, no way of knowing what's on it without slotting it. Should I take the cred stick? No, let's leave it. Put the purple shirt. Terrible that we have been long to say I'm sorry. See you there. Love, Jessica. Oh, fucking Jessica. Let's take it. Slot the grit stick into your PDA. Nice. Through the bag. Put down the evidence bag. Oh, hey. What's going on? Towering over the diminutive coroner is a homicide detective right out of central casting. Vic. Wow. So you insisted at the time. He chortles. Come on, she offed herself. It had on very good authority. I had it on very good authority that she did it herself. Let's go, Dresden. Give me something to work with here. The Ripper case is my ticket to Lieutenant's badge. Well, they're staying true to the Shadowrunner lingo. That's pretty good. Well, the dialect is pretty well researched. Already posted everything I know. The killer stuns the target with a combination of drugs and magic, then removes a single internal organ while they're still alive. Right-handed with a slim hand that knows its way around a scalpel. Maybe he's an elf! Whacked-out surgeon. Any surgeons should still use scalpels anymore. These aids all done with computer-controlled lasers. Could be anyone from a military field surgeon to an antique medicine aficionado. You're no don't help. Lone Star Detective finally notices you. Notice superhuman powers of observation. He's Captain Obvious. Aw, I can't intimidate him. Huh. I'm the nobody who didn't hear nothing. That's right. And if you ever do hear something, I'll knock it right out of your head. You're not supposed to do that, copper. Dresden, get me more. I'm putting someone in a cell or a box this week, and I'm claiming my promotion. What a guy. I certainly hope that the quests aren't, like, way too straightforward and linear. Shadowrun is all about trying to piece together evidence and, like, non-subtle clues. Pieces of information that are impossible to find otherwise without help. We'll see. You always make friends that easily? Huh, great at dinner parties, too. I don't do friends. You didn't really seem like my type. Cocks his head to one side. Be straight with me. You're really gonna work for the dead man? Job's a job. Street justice. Isn't interested in anything but Detective McCluskey. He'd convict his own mother if it meant another 10 million a week in his paycheck. Plus, he's on the take. You have honor after fashion. I try to honor the dead in my work, so at least we have that in common. What can I do to help you? Who's paying to hold his leash? What are organs worth these days? Body can be worth a bunch of nuyen, but individual organs not worth much anymore. Organ grinders only deal... and it only deals in the recently deceased. There's plenty of other chop shops that aren't as picky, though. They don't care where the bodies come from. That's not good. Doctors still learn how to use them in their first year of medical school, as do coroners, but neither profession uses them much anymore. It's possible some of the slimier chop shops still use scalpels, I suppose, but I wouldn't know where to look. What do you say about his mum? This reports she committed suicide about a year ago. Are you the official in that sentence? My name's on the report, but my actual findings left some doubts. Can't say that it wasn't suicide, but there were unusual bruises on her upper arms and she didn't use her dominant hand to pull the trigger. I was told to drop it, so I dropped it. Which means you got strong-armed out of your theory. It's a nearby club in the Barrens that attracts lowlifes. You'll probably like it. What are you trying to say? I'm not really a going out type. Always too much to be done around here. Plus, the dead are just easier to get along with. I like how this game started in a morgue just like the Super Nintendo one did. I like it. I like it. Or you're not creative. I don't know. One more thing. Where was he killed? So I gained 2 karma. Now I might be able to do you one better. Why don't you poke around those body lockers in the back and see if you find anything? Do you know where the murder site is or not? I'll go do that. I like to be surprised. Take a slap patch. Basic med kit. Dock wagon basic trauma kit. There's a body locker. Cold storage drawer is labeled John Doe, but the internal thermostat is set to 21 degrees Celsius. Open the drawer. Cold storage drawer opens to reveal the fully clothed body of a man, arms folded across his chest, in addition to sporting some of the brightest orange hair you've ever seen. The body seems to be in very good condition. Oh, there he is. There's Jake Armitage. Whoa, easy there. I swear I didn't know that was going to happen. In one quick move, he jumps down from the drawer. He stands before you. For someone who just woke up in a morgue locker, he seems unfazed and pretty well put together. Spot a data jack drilled into his temples and some shamanistic tattoos peeking above his collar. Told John to wake me up at 6 in the morning. Is it 6 yet? It doesn't feel like 6 yet. I've had an alarm clock. Give me a break, chummer. I haven't had my soykoff yet. Much for a good night's sleep. On the plus side, I notice you haven't killed me yet, so that's good. If you aren't after me, then what's your story? Latest victim. Playing dead, mostly. A bunch of gangsters out there want my head, and I'd rather keep it. Figured I'd lay low for a while, give them some time to cool down. Jake yells toward the other side of the room. John, is this guy cool? He's on the level, working for Sam, believe it or not. Dead man's switch. Thought you could help him out. Name's Jake, and you are? Call me Blorch. I like Jake. I'll be nice to him. Well-mannered, too. Such a rare thing in this city. Sounds like you're taking a dive into the deep end here. John's right. I might be able to help you out. Hanging out at the Seamstress's Union. Tripped out and rowdy. Laying low for the few days after a bad run. Miss Kavoda asked me to throw Sam out, so I did. Out in the alley, some gangsters got the jump on me. Maybe I need some soykoff after all. Get your own damn cup. My hands are dirty anyway. What's wrong with this intestine? Squelching as Dresden continues his work. You're a real pal. Anyway, there's a big fat corp bounty on my head. Like I said, job didn't go exactly according to plan out in the alley. Halloweeners got the jump on us. Damn gangers. Thought they could turn a quick profit off my head. Sam stumbled off during the fight, though, and that's the last I saw of him until he turned up here, dead on arrival. Let's see. Excuse me, Mrs. Simpson, your husband is DOA. Oh my god, he's dead? I mean DWI. I always get those two mixed up. And his body a block away from the Union? Around broad daylight. That's a Barrens for you. Shame though, wish you'd been there. Those slagging gangers hadn't come along. Tell you what. Handle yourself in a fight. I could use some backup to settle the score with those Halloweeners out there. Your leader's got the whole gang searching the Barrens for me. Need to get rid of that asshole. I like a good revenge side mission. Let's do it. Take you to the place Sam was murdered? You know, throw in some decent supplies while we're at it. What do you say? Fight, I get paid in Nui and not tours. Count me in. hiding out over out here ever since that run-in with those Halloweeners, whiny bunch of gangers, but this stretch of the Barrens is their turf. Packing some heat. Sleep in the dumpster tomorrow. Need a weapon? I do want a pistol, because I have ranged weapon now. Let's go with pistol, because that's where our skills are. Fischetti, security 500. Evening on the town. Let's go. They're not looking for you. Alright, now let's figure out how to get to a menu. Let's see, hit escape to go to the menu here. This looks like equipment. It's version 1.0 of me, or of the game, I don't know. Let's see. I guess that's equipped by default. No cyberware. I got 2 karma, so maybe I can spend it. Yeah, there's these things up here that you can do as well. And you can scroll down. I missed that earlier. It wasn't entirely obvious. Oh, I see. These are like bookmarks. I gotcha. I read you. I don't have any magic, so that's not gonna work. Body's not gonna work. Let's upgrade ranged combat. Jake Armitage. He has no karma to spend. You gotta keep switching each time you click these little things. That's annoying. He's got spells, so he's magic. Magical Jake. Submission item, nothing yet. Alright, let's do this. Let's get on out of here. After 40 minutes or so, we're out into the Barrens. Gonna go find some gangers. The Redmond Barrens. Redmond is not really anywhere near Seattle, but maybe it doesn't matter. I stashed just around the corner in the alley. Game auto-saved. There's a dude waiting for the bus. I wonder if we'll see Microsoft. Hello, lady. If you need soy cough, here you go. Orcs are my favorite. How about you say that to anybody? See. Stash. It's not really obvious that I clicked on that thing to pick it up. Hidden in the garbage-strewn alley is a high-tech safe with a mag card reader on the front. Open it up. Let's see. Take the gear. Killing hands. Whoa, what is this? Hand over the loot, bozos. I think you should fuck off. Alright, what are my options? So I can do aim shot or single shot. Not really sure how to cast magic yet. Got him. Let's just kill him. And he won't hit the guy who's not armed. 57% chance to hit. Let's move over here. See what we can do with 73%. Dead. So welcome to the Barrens. Guess I'll need to find a new spot to hide my gear. Good dead drops are hard to keep. Same dreck in every city. So I shouldn't invest in real estate. Huh, only by the hour. Deal with the Halloweeners gang. Got some gear, let's go deal with those bitches. Is that their idea of a random encounter? It's the worried man can talk to us. I don't know you, but you look like you handled yourself in a fight and we need some help. What's your problem? Shaking down the market we've set up here. It's been getting worse lately. I don't think we can afford to pay them anymore. No one will stand up and Lone Star isn't about to get involved. Where is it? Mrs. James. Whew, she'll reward me. That's goddamn right. Sweet. Keep heading north. You'll see it. Hello. Are you Mrs. James? Far from downtrodden. It's not my business, but I wouldn't go that way. Frag off. Stirring up trouble again. She points to the south. So the Halloweeners are that way. Those are the guys we're after. Big old troll named John Paul. Real piece of work, even for a wiener. Ha! It's a funny abbreviation. Yep, that's him. Nice. They're a tough bunch. Don't say I didn't warn you. Let's go gain some experience on these assholes. Commerce is like a weed taking root in the cracks of the crevices of the world whenever it can. A small street market has flourished here amidst the crumbling buildings of the Redmond Barons. Look, mate, just pay up. Barely have anything left. Oh, you're dead, tattoo on the neck guy. Use his bulk and hideous breath to intimidate the shopkeeper. Who the hell are you? Can't do anything. I'd like to pay for... Heard about you, why don't you piss off? But your mom's real proud of you. Since we can't do anything but piss him off anyway, let's try to be clever about it. I don't see a badge, so why don't you mind your own? Gutter punks? Caustatic. Dash, ice this guy. Ow. Don't you hit me with the club. Weak. Let's see. Let's kill the bitch with the magic. 91% chance to hit and you missed. Fuck that. Let's get this guy. Wow. A shoddy. God, fucking A. Gotta really work on this randomizing thing. Speak with the bullied merchant. Do I get my health back after each encounter? Doesn't look like it. That must be what the medkits are for. Not just in battle, but out of battle as well. Can't thank you enough. It's the least we can do. Let's take it. Probably get more karma if you let him keep it. Isn't that what karma is like? Isn't that what the definition of karma is? Pay it forward and all that shit. It's out here. See, I probably have a quest log. Redmond Barons. Items. What's my status? Hit points 44 out of how many, bro? Their options. Autosave is what's keeping me from not quitting. Let's see. Autosave keeps me from losing my progress as I make death out of all these assholes. Who's Vlad? Man size you up. You can see his age old fight or flight equation running back. Man has drug clouded eyes. Hey man, are you okay? Yes, no, yes, I saw something. It's going to kill me. Calm down. I'm Blorch. Are you a shaman? Yeah. So that spirit's so dark, so alien that, yeah? Across the street from the Seamstress's Union. It's not going to kill you. You're safe. You want a hug? Okay. Rack off stump. What that says? Stump legs. All right. What do we got? There's a pumpkin on the ground. Oh, and there's a thug. Halloweener Century. Hey, Asswipes, take another step forward and we're going to plant you right there. This Halloweener property, no? This is the one of the two who got away. If I hadn't missed my shot, these idiots would have all given up and moved on by now. You're rolling with Jake, bad idea, Chimmer. The Halloweeners are collecting that bounty and killing you? Well, that'll be a nice bonus. How can there already be a bounty on my head? I haven't done anything. Increased accuracy. 10%. Let's do it. That asshole guy. You lose. Now where's your chummer? Ouch. 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 21%. Let's move over here. 50. Let's get you. You missed. All right. The little shield represents the amount of cover you get. It's a strong bitch. Got him. Alright, let's get some half cover here. 8 damage, holy shit. There you go. Uh-oh. John Paul. Time to run away. Crit 12. Missed. You fuck. Let's see. That makes the thing go away. I can unarmed. How do I use items? Is that what this is? Basic med kit. Guess I really don't have to use that just yet. Healing hands, physical adept. And lethal weapons for 4 rounds. Increasing damage by 10 HP. That's how you use magic. That's... alright. I'm running away. Flamethrower. Don't miss. God damn it. You serious? Whoa, uncle, I was just playing with you. I'll call off the rest of the Halloweeners, Jake. Call it even, yeah? Dirtbags like you don't need second chances. Lower your weapon and walk away. What do you think, Jake? I'm already at shoot on sight status with these guys. Killing John Paul means one less wiener to shoot me in the back while I'm buying smokes. Seems there's a profit in it. Let's finish this. Oh shit. Nice. Is it the murder site? All right. I suppose. Got about an hour in or so, almost. We should go to the murder site. And then I'll probably call it good. We need to use some items. Blorch. That's heals you or any team member consumed when used. That's keep me alive. Dan the Donut Man. Wish I had a mini map or something. That must be the objective. Hey, Dan the Donut Man, what's up? What can I get you? Did you see the murder? Nope, it was closed when it happened, but hey, this is the Barons. Can you tell me? I have to ask, you probably shouldn't be out here. Stretch Royal is called Touristville, though. That's clever. That's original. I suppose it's the closest thing around here to respectable. Fewer muggings, and you might even survive drinking the water. If you're lucky, wouldn't recommend it, though. Give me a donut. Alright, what is this that I just got? Soy cough and donut. Not really sure what it's for, but it'll be for somebody, because that's mission item. Seamstress's Union. Hey, Bobby. Tasty morsel for each every world. It's just what every well-dressed Shadowrunner should have in his back pocket. Combat stim that increases body plus 2. Five rounds. No thanks. Best place to party. We go in. As laughter music emanate from within, but you should finish your investigation first. The interaction points are a little hard to notice until after you're sort of like within range with your cursor. Can be sort of annoying. Nerp, spy them at your local S-squared. Like how Jake just hangs way the hell back there. I'm close, come back tomorrow. You know what happened? We're behind Union, a couple seconds later, this guy comes out, runs across the street, didn't get a good look at him, then all the lights in the alley exploded all of a sudden, things got pretty quiet. He didn't go running over. Kind of thing gets you killed. Thanks for your time, even though you are not much help. Thank you, Sally. This does not look good. Flashing red and blue lights up ahead. Hold up a minute. Lone Star isn't above collecting on a corp-issued bounty. And the one on my head isn't going away anytime soon. I think this is where our paths diverge. Thanks again for your help. It's a good thing I didn't heal him, because that would have sucked. That's the mistake, or that's the risk you take in RPGs, though, is doing stuff with party members that are not permanent. Here's your payment. They don't take knowing where I'm going, and it looks like you could use the funds. Give me a call when you're in the clear. Sure you don't want to stick around? Not my style. Besides, you seem like you could take care of yourself. Maybe this is where he goes off to do Shadowrun on the Super Nintendo, even though they take Nui in there, so that probably is not it. One more thing, checking out Pal's crime scene, pop in the Seamstress Union just down the street. You need gear, information, or just a damn stiff drink, that's the place to be. Best dive this side of Chicago. Nice. Nice knowing you. See you later, Jake. I really like the graphics and the style. It's bordering on too cartoony, but it's a game where you have made-up races and like character classes, so I guess I don't know how picky I can be. It's pretty good for somebody that just did all this from the ground up, though. Bright yellow police tape cuts through the darkness. Cop looks cold and hungry. Maybe I'll give him the Soykoff and donut. Trying to explain you can't. This is an official Lone Star investigation. I can't let anyone in here. Hey man, I got rights. Look, you sinless garbage. I've got a job to do. Find a new blanket or find a reason to use my stun baton. Wow. That's very rude. Cold, so I picked up a donut at some Soykoff. Nice. That's why it's a mission item. What can I do for you? Dead man to help find his killer? Do I want to tell him? I'm gonna lie. Dig in. Huh. Fucking internal affairs. Let's pull some heavy rain here and examine the murder site. The text box is in the way. I don't like that. Examine the area. Bar tab receipt. Seamstress Union dated 302, 2 days ago. Work light is new. Close inspection seems they've all imploded. This one foreshadowed them all at the same time. There's the magnifying glass. And that's annoying that that thing's in the way and I can't read that. Fix it. So I don't know what it says. That's kind of obnoxious. That could make things difficult later. Alright, well, I visited the murder site. Now it's time to go to the Seamstress's Union. But this is going to be a task for another day. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of First Fireups Shadowrun Returns. From what I can see so far, it's definitely worth putting in more than just the first hour. I am a big fan of the Shadowrun series, and I'll admit that I haven't played a lot of the tabletop games, but I definitely enjoyed Shadowrun on the Super Nintendo, and was really excited to hear about this game coming out. I like this type of game. I did a back of the box review on XCOM Enemy Unknown. You know, that's another fun game that's done. This game is done in that style, so if you like that, go check it out. The interface feels a little clunky on this game. The music is pretty good. The graphics are really nice. The character dialogue is entertaining. So all in all, I'd have to say that this one is definitely worth your time. Definitely worth $20. The guy that the team that developed this, Harebrained Schemes, is definitely got their work cut out for them. I'll be interested in checking out the rest of this mission and possibly some user-generated content later, and I encourage you guys to do the same. So once again, thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, go ahead and follow me on Facebook and Twitter. I'll put the links in the description. You can see everything else that I'm up to, status updates and other videos and things that you might find entertaining on my channel. So have a good night, and I'll see you all later.